Hey there. Welcome to Life Noggin. A post-apocalyptic world can seem pretty cool in video games and movies, but it would be a whole lot scarier in real life, especially if it had to do with nuclear warfare. I'm interested on what a nuclear blast would do to the human body, and hopefully we can learn why we should try and avoid such things in the future. For starters, just what is a nuclear bomb? A nuclear bomb is a name generally given to a weapon that's explosion is the result of energy released by a reaction involving atomic nuclei. This is typically done through fission, usually powered by uranium or plutonium, or fusion, which is more powerful and usually involves hydrogen. Fission supplies the main damaging power for atomic bombs, whereas fusion is involved for hydrogen bombs. As such, both the atomic bomb and the hydrogen bomb are nuclear weapons. However, it's interesting to point out that fusion bombs can still use fission with regards to detonating or triggering the bomb. So what could a nuclear blast do to the human body? Well, nuclear explosions can produce blasts of air similar to more conventional weapons. The blast can injure the human body through effects such as rupturing eardrums or lungs, or by throwing people at dangerous speeds. Collapsing structures and flying debris caused by the blast can also lead to injury. This can range anywhere from smaller scrapes and wounds to a person's bones being crushed. Death can occur if the damage is bad enough. Even if they don't die immediately, it can be possible for a person to be buried under rubble that they can't escape from. But a nuclear blast has another level of harm that can hurt the human body. Beyond the effects we just talked about, it can generate an intense pulse of thermal radiation that can burn people's skin and start fires. It's typically worse the closer a person is to the center of the blast, with the possibility of their insides being roasted alive and their body even being incinerated if they were close enough. The blast can also lead to more long-term health consequences, such as cataracts, and after effects have been seen in cases like Hiroshima that involve problems like thyroid disease. Some also believe it can lead to birth defects. Nuclear blasts have yet another layer of harm that is both bad for the human body and the environment. Fallout. What does nuclear fallout do to the human body? A big danger comes in the form of cancer and radiation. When exposed to the radiation from nuclear fallout, it can cause a chemical change in a person's cells, which can kill or make the cells abnormal. If the cell's DNA is damaged, this can lead to cancer. Nuclear blasts can be very devastating, with significant short and long-term consequences. So, hopefully, we can just keep our studies on nuclear weapons a history lesson. Let me know in the comment section below what we should talk about next. And if you enjoyed this video, then you're definitely going to want to check out the video we did over on Play Noggin about whether or not you could survive a nuclear fallout.
Using this system, the most powerful weapons in the United States' current arsenal can unleash the equivalent of 1.2 million tons or megatons of TNT. That's 75 times more energy than the first atomic weapons.
As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.